What's up? Great morning, day 26. Let's bring it open. I don't know how many of you know this song. Played it one time. It's the video from YouTube that says free hugs.
I don't like illusions, I can't see them clearly.
Great morning, folks. What's up, Linda? What's up, Camille? What's up, Susan? Betty?
I don't mind. I don't care. As long as you're here. Go ahead, tell me you leave again. You'll just come back running. Holding your sky high in hand.
Good morning, Betty. What's up, Jill?
It's all the same. And I'll take you for who you are. If you take me for everything.
What's up, Mish?
Do
good morning.
It all over again. It's all the same.
What's up, family? Welcome to day 26. 26, 27, 28, 28 day shred. So today is really just about looking at those 3 days, really. I know the perception is that it's 2 days, but looking at those 3 days, and we could look at it in a simple way, finishing it strong, but you know, maybe also qualifying the value of what we've done and the value of really going after it. You know, I've been thinking a lot about this idea of going to get it lately. And, you know, anytime somebody ever asks me why I'm doing something, or like, hey, you know, take it easy. You know, like, are you ever gonna stop? And all that stuff. It makes me realize the reason why they say that, and the reason why my mind says that, are you ever gonna stop, is because I don't know about you, but I've been trained to not 100% follow through. Like, I've been trained to always have a stopping point. So I don't know if that's ever gonna not be there, because every morning I wake up, I wonder if it's the last day that I will do this routine. You know, I woke up this morning and I drove all day yesterday. I had an amazing experience with Dr. Ray. If you didn't watch that video, please go watch it. It'll probably be below this one in the shred, and share it. Share it. I think like 60 people shared it. It's gonna blow up, and his words are just gold. But I'm fatigued. You know, I'm fatigued this morning from all that. I got some great sleep, but I'm just constantly playing in my mind, and it's unconscious, by the way, and this will get into the theme. I'm always playing in my mind this idea that I deserve a break, or I should take a couple days off, and all that stuff. And I understand why, because that's, I've been trained. I've actually been trained. I've been in training my whole life to not be a quitter per se, because there's nothing wrong with taking some time to relax and stuff. But I acknowledge the power, the unconscious power that it has over me sometimes. Anyway, the theme that I had, I don't know where I got this, but what I realized is that, you know, I was going through my motions this morning, and, you know, oh, by the way, so whenever somebody asks me, or maybe asks you, why are you doing this? Why are you so excessively doing this? And you always get up early in the morning. And by the way, not everybody has to do it your way or my way, but my answer to them is, I always say, because I'm going to get it. And they say, well, going to get what? And I said, it. I've got my it. You've got your it. So I'm going to get my it, you know, because I don't want to feel like shit. That's the way I interpret it. But anyway, I was thinking about this idea of breaking free. You know, if you look at my Facebook page, I have this picture that I love of somebody like breaking the chains. And I was realizing that the reason why I think the way I do, and you probably do too, is because we're unconsciously paralyzed. Now, here's what that means. Being unconsciously paralyzed is when you get paralyzed. Like if you're ever having that feeling that you're just, you can't function or move forward, and somebody says, what's up, what's going on? You might label it as something, but what's probably really going on is you don't know. You don't know. And that's that part of that elephant on the chain thing. Remember, a huge elephant, you go to a circus and he's just got this teeny little chain around his ankle. At his size, he can just kick his foot and break free from it, but he's been trained unconsciously to think that he's trapped. So that's what it means to be unconsciously paralyzed is, you know, we've spent so much time in the herd in our life, and here we are now stepping out of the herd. And you know what, Dr. Ray really rings true when he's talking. Go look at that. Share this, share that, share it, share everything, right? If you like something, share it with somebody else. You might save their life. But anyway, he was just talking about that, you know, we get attached to the goal very often, but you'll hear him constantly talk about the idea of doing simple things every day and creating consistency and discipline behind them. And that's where the win is down the road. We get so attached to a goal that we put everything into it. So naturally on a day we don't feel like it, that doing everything is too much. So the genius behind my mentor and this man is this idea of building transformational micro habits over time that make you a person down the road, like me this morning, that experiences the feeling of, hey, why don't you take a break? Hey, back off a little bit. Are you gonna do this your whole life? You know? And I'm not gonna tell you that it's easy in my situation because I still struggle through it. Sometimes I have to go through the motions, but I will tell you it's easier, you know? So are you interested in becoming, you know, the kind of person that it's easier for you to fight through those days, you know? Because I would assume that after I go through this again in March, it will become even more easier. So unconsciously paralyzed, you know, is this state that I believe the herd is in. They don't even know it. That's why it's called unconsciously. So let's say that we all of a sudden become conscious and we work on things and we're disciplined and we have consistency, which is what you're doing. Here's the value of what you're doing. If we continue to do these little things, I gotta tell you something, waking up in the morning and being here in this environment, like I was at Dr. A's and I would wake up in the morning and I would run around his property, which is a little bit challenging because I'd be like dodging the dog poop and stuff, which was part of the workout. And then I would run down to the dock and I was doing some silly things. It was actually like 6 a.m. and I didn't know anybody was watching me. His neighbor saw me and I was like walking like a freak, you know, because I am. I feel good, I feel comfortable in that space now. But I was just stopping every now and then and saying, man, are you doing this for something else or are you actually enjoying this? And I was enjoying it. I was feeling so good about it. So the discipline, the consistency, and all of these daily practices, we might be thinking that it's for the scale to move or to get a body fat percentage. And those are wins. But I believe, and this was my focus this morning, that what it really is we're becoming consciously free. See, we're gonna go from being unconsciously paralyzed, right? Unconsciously paralyzed to unconsciously free. Here's what that means. Unconsciously free is when you all of a sudden notice that you carry a water bottle around without thinking about it. Unconsciously free is when you get up in the morning and you start doing fun, crazy stuff in your routines and you say thank you and you get in a mindset of how I can help and all that stuff. And it doesn't bother you and it's not an effort, right? You're unconsciously free from the paralyzed feeling. So that's the value of it. So what am I working towards? That's what I'm gonna say today to people. People are gonna say, what are you trying to accomplish here? You know, it's so funny how people, if people see you running, it's that outshining effect. If people see you going for it and going to get it in life and they're not going to get it, they start to question you and say, well, that's stupid. Why would you do that? So I always say, I'm going to get it. And if they need more definition, I say I'm looking to become unconsciously free, meaning completely feeling free and not even understanding why. Because as we always say now here, Matt Mialy came up with this, is that's the new normal. The new normal in this world, which is a little teeny little world, right, is to become unconsciously free. And remember, Les Brown, who I love, he says, you know, it's lonely at the top. Right? So you guys are all at the top here, right? And more people are coming in now because you guys share this and you say, hey, check this out. It's lonely at the top, very crowded at the bottom. It's very crowded at the bottom. So I don't know about you, but I don't like crowds. I like to speak to crowds, but I don't like to be amongst crowds of common, common people, because the power is pretty strong. They suck you back in. You might end up smoking cigarettes if you hang around with that crowd too much. So another thought I had was, what does it mean to you when thinking about achieving good things, right? I know we all want to achieve good things, but just check yourself on that, because a lot of us spend a lot of time in fake work land. And what that means is, you know, play with that idea of achieving good things. Like, how do you know you're achieving good things? Are you only thinking about helping others? Because we're all angels from heaven, right? And we want to just be in service of others, and we don't want nothing from nobody, right? So we get caught up on achieving good things is only about helping others or being a good person. Or do you think that stuff as well, right? Do you look at that stuff as well as things for yourself? See, you've been taught that being selfish is a bad thing, right? But meanwhile, you don't think, say, or do anything without it having personal value for you, right? You are all selfish to the core, and that's what I love about you. So just think about that for a second. When you say, today I am going to achieve good things, right? You'll find yourself spending a lot of time doing things for others, your boss, your friends, your family. What about you? What about you today, right? So maybe in the comments before I close out, tell me what it means for you to achieve good things for you. Now, I know you'll protect yourself like I do and say, but doing things for others is for me. I get it. But I want you to be selfish today and talk a little bit about achieving good things for you, getting in great shape, making more money, being happier, all that stuff. So here's a hall pass. Go be selfish today. what else did I write? This was great. This I got from Les Brown. He says, you know, Dr. A always talks about how motivation is a waste of your time, because if you're waiting to be motivated, right, you might be waiting for a long time. Because looking for motivation, your motivation is something that you have to wait for an external force to help you out. That's out of your control. You might be sitting around for days, weeks, months, years, a lifetime, waiting to become motivated. Don't wait to become motivated. Don't search for motivation. Have courage, right? And here's the difference. Motivation is dependent on something else. Courage is something that you can decide to do any day. It's inside of you. You know exactly what you're supposed to do, and all you need to do is have courage. And if you wait for motivation, this is what Les Brown says. He says, be careful. If you wait for motivation, sooner or later, life is gonna make a move on you, right? And then you're gonna have a really big motivation. It's called the motivation of desperation. So are you waiting around for life to potentially move on you, that mortality motivation? Or do you think that it would be a good idea to have courage and make a move on life? Let's make a move on life. There's my cue. And then I love this idea, and I tried to say this yesterday with Dr. A, but it said, don't be the king or queen that you were born to be and never be crowned upon. So you know how we always say be frowned upon? You know, you were born to be great. You were born to be, trust me, I had a conversation with God the other day, and I said, do you want something good for them? And he's like, yes, oh my God, right? So are you a king or a queen that's never been crowned upon, right? And therefore being frowned upon? Anyway, I love that. So you know, think about what it means to achieve good things today. Think about the value of going to get it, these next 3 days. I'm looking at these next 3 days to prep myself. I'm setting my goals for March now. We're gonna do that in business and everything like that today. Today's a great day to start setting your goals, but guess what happens if you go all in these next 2-3 days? Those goals become exciting, right? And then maybe really go watch the video with Dr. Ray again and just listen to his words about making it fun, making it easy, the wall push-up concept, he said. And picking something like we're doing here that you can do every day and building the discipline and becoming unconsciously free. Who wants to be unconsciously free? I don't know. I just feel great. I don't even know why, but I just feel amazing. Love and appreciate you. Listen to the song. Hours slide and days go by till you decide to come. And in between it always seems too long for certain. But I have the skill, yeah, I have the will to breathe you in while I can. However long you stay. It's all that I am. I don't mind. I don't care. I gotta play this out. The end is so good.